Now, obviously, working for Cobb, you are a little bit biased. However, I know from your background, you've dealt with many aftermarket standalone ECUs. I kind of alluded at the start of this chat to the fact that that line between where we need to go to an aftermarket ECU is becoming more blurred. Yeah. Have you got like a line in the sand of what you consider to be a point where a standalone makes more sense, or is there really no limit now?
That's a great question. I think as we continue developing this product, allow it to daisy chain and bring more and more things in, we push that boundary further and further. Currently, I'd say input-output limitations on the really big race cars are one of the things that's a common concern. You know, if you want to bring in four EGTs and or six EGTs on a GTR, you know, maybe six wideband, something like that, that's not something we can currently facilitate. And ultimately, even at a place like TX2K, where we've got the wildest of the wild, there's still a pretty small percentage of folks that are looking to do that. So, for example, English and ETS have been out here running sevens on our product years ago, you know, probably 4 or 5 years ago at this point. So people have certainly shown you can go really fast with what we've got, and we've added quite a bit more since then. So we'll just keep pushing.
So essentially, you've got a product here that's probably going to be a pretty suitable option for 98% of people exactly. that want to go fast.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're certainly not looking to be that 100%. What we'd really love to do is offer something that meets most customer needs at a reasonable price, make it easy to tune, keep our tuners happy, everybody happy.